Just as he was a great artist, Eduardo Castrillo was a devout family man. Married to Rosa Ana Luarca, the couple was blessed with three talented children.
Si Ed kasi masyadong tahimik, very deep. Kaya kung meron siyang mga gustong express, depende sa mood niya. Normally, thinker. Tsaka minsan, kakain kami. Nag-prepare ako ng magandang meal sa kanya, like kunwari, beef steak. Alam mo pa na hindi kumain, kinuha yung sketch pad niya, naupo lang doon, at nag-sketch ng sketch. Nag-design siya, nag-design. Ganun lang ugali niya. Pero as a father, very loving, very protective sa kanyang mga anak. Nung maliit ang mga bata, mahilig siyang bumili ng mga clay. At yung tatlong anak namin, talagang at an early age, 2-3 years old, nagmumold na sila ng mga animals, giraffe, elephant, especially yung eldest son namin na si Meyer. Pero lahat sila may mga artistic inclination kasi yung eye nila, yung mga pangkaraniwang tao na hindi nakikita, nakikita ng mga anak namin. Itong aking panganay, parang more of daddy niya. Mas medyo malalim at saka tahimik. Yung second son namin, siya medyo chubby. Tumutulong sa kanya sa studio niya. Pero itong aking babaeng bunsong only daughter namin, very aggressive, very strong, at saka very artistic din. Nagko-compose ng song, naggawa ng book, at saka nag-sculpt, nagpipaint.
Miero, Nixio, and Ovian learned about art from the master himself, and today are continuing their father's legacy. With backgrounds in engineering, education, and business administration, Miero El Castrillo has had many experiences in managing projects, coordinating with people, and supervising challenging endeavors. He was the project manager of the Gat Andres Bonifacio Shrine in the city of Manila, as well as historical tableaus of the heritage of Cebu and the heritage of Misamis Oriental. Miero's artistic gifts allow him to communicate and deliver the rudiments of the meticulous and history-specific designs drawn up by his father, and with his scientific and logical mind, these projects are executed seamlessly.
Actually, I just started works when my dad passed away the other year. It was also a means for me to more or less express how I felt and represent my relationship with him. Although in the previous years, in the 90s, when I managed some of his works or monuments in the other cities, I'd be dabbling already in the arts. By making some of the minor pieces for his big projects. When we were growing up in his studio, he would show us, you know, how things were done and the technique. Actually, his technique is also the technique he uses for his bigger pieces and monuments and medium-sized pieces, but it's precisely the same technique he uses also for his jewelry pieces. I feel the best influence that he's imparted or left with us is ang kultura natin, ang pagka-Pilipino natin, na pakita rin natin sa mundo, na we're actually bigger than we think we are. The legacy that I want to live up to, uphold also what he stood for as a Filipino and as an artist, a creative artist. He has designs of cars or even caskets, also buildings na never nagawa. And that was what, way when we were born even. So even in the 60s or the 70s, he had all those ideas already. And one of his wishes actually was, sana during his lifetime magawa niya. Pero kung ngayon nawala na siya, na sinasabi niya rin sa amin dati, na kung ano yung kaya naman ipagpatuloy, ipagpatuloy na lang. Tapos pakita rin sa mundo kung ano yung ano natin as a Filipino.
Miero's children are also into visual and performing arts. Natalia Dominique, or Nadine, who is 16 years old, has been writing poems and short stories since she was 7 and has been involved in theater during summers. Alessandra, who is 10 years old, loves ballet, while 7-year-old Cecilia Amaris is into imaginative play and dancing. But it is Regina Gabriel Oraya, who has always been into drawing, sketching, painting, and creating with clay. She created her first sculpture with her lolo at the age of 10. We will meet another Castrillo family member who has found his own artistic voice when My City, My SM, My Art returns.